All right, so you're an entrepreneur and you want to start a business. Should you incorporate? Well, you can set it up as a sole proprietorship, in which case you simply report your business income on your personal tax return, or you can set up a corporation. Sexy, right? Everyone's doing it. A corporation is a separate legal entity and comes with its own set of pros and cons. There are legal reasons for incorporating, such as creditor protection, but the primary tax driver is the ability to defer taxes and potentially access the lifetime capital gains exemption. What does it mean to defer taxes? Well, in Alberta, at least at the time of the video, certain small business corporations are taxed at a low rate of 11% in comparison with personal tax rates upwards of 48%. This creates the opportunity to defer upwards 37% in taxes, meaning you'll pay those taxes later when you pull the money out. So how exactly does this work? Well, you still need to pay personal taxes on any money you take out of your corporation, but if you limit what you take out to what you need, then you can defer taxes on any remaining cash that's left in the corporation. For example, let's say that your business nets 175 grand. And you require 75 grand gross salary for your lifestyle. You'll still need to pay corporate taxes on the 100 grand left over, 11%, so 11 grand, but you can defer the remaining amount, the cash left over, and invest it in your business. Beef up your marketing, buy another welding truck, hire another employee. If you don't need the cash for the business, you can invest in passive assets such as stocks or real estate. Note, however, that investment income is taxed at a high rate, and there are complex rules around passive investments that you should understand before investing inside a corporation. There are ways to split income, lowering your overall family tax burden, but this is pretty limited now. And when allowed, there are complex rules around this that need to be navigated in order to do it properly. You may take advantage of the lifetime capital gains exemption, which shelters $867,000 of capital gains from taxes when you sell your company, assuming it qualifies, to a third party. So, should you incorporate? Well, there's really no clear-cut answer, but if you have a successful business and can retain cash in the company, then it's likely a good idea. Keep in mind that there are upfront and recurring annual costs associated with incorporating, so you want to make sure it makes sense before pulling the trigger. If you have questions, I'm happy to talk about your individual situation.